Expedite, the pre-workout is designed to really help you get through those moments where you feel a little fatigued. Sometimes your body does get a little tired, you know, gets a little sore. But this kind of stuff picks you right back up.
Todos sabemos que estamos during COVID-19, todos encerrados por un año. ¿Qué hiciste para estar activo y pues luchar contra esta pandemia?
No, pues a mí el COVID no me hizo nada, al contrario, yo batí el COVID. Todos los días he corrido, no he tenido descanso, todos los días he hecho un lado del COVID, he estado trabajando, gracias a Dios, mi COVID. Y todos los días hay que correr, no pasa nada, no estoy diciendo que no, el COVID no sea real, pero hay que darle el visto bueno a las cosas malas que están pasando y a correr. Y ahora estamos aquí con esta oportunidad, gracias a Marvin, a Marvin Nelson por esta oportunidad, gracias a Dios, gracias al gran campeón, que es una leyenda, Montana Barrera, por esta gran oportunidad de pelear el día 11, entonces una exhibición. Pero aún así, siendo una exhibición, yo creo que tanto como él como yo somos unos peleadores arriba de ti. Vamos a entregar todo. Vamos a entregar todo, vamos a hacer el mejor show que se pueda. Que gane mejor. Y es un honor, ¿verdad? Pelear o hacer una exhibición con este. Ese es una leyenda, él es un verdadero campeón. Yo soy un peleador que no fui campeón mundial, tuve mis títulos, pero estamos en. Ya no voy a pelear más, lo he hecho lo mejor por ustedes, porque ustedes son mi familia, ustedes son los que me han hecho el Soto Caraz que soy. Gracias a ustedes.
Gracias, Jesús. Y unas palabras del legendario, de la leyenda, Hall of Famer, Marco Antonio Barrera. Marco, ¿me puedes participar conmigo? ¿Puedes platicar un poquito por qué tú mantuviste esta decisión de regresar al ring para esta exhibición? Y cómo, también la misma pregunta, cómo estuviste durante el COVID este año pasado y cómo te has mantenido en tu física, pues.
Bueno, primeramente, muy buenas tardes a todos. Es la primera vez que vengo para Pico Rivera. He andado por todo California, pero es la primera vez, y presentarme ante este público y llevarme el respaldo a los futuros campeones del mundo, que aquí los tenemos, para mí va a ser maravilloso poder poner un granito de arena en la exhibición con Soto Caraz, que es un guerrero. Me tocó verlo transmitir sus funciones por TV Azteca, donde yo trabajaba. Entonces ahora tenerlo arriba del cuadrilátero creo que va a ser algo emocionante. Esta pandemia exhibición es como para olvidar un poquito, ¿no? Llevamos un año y meses recluidos de lo que fue la pandemia, entonces queremos darle tanto Soto Caraz como a su servidor un espectáculo diferente, hacer olvidar esa noche a la gente, más de un año que llevamos con la pandemia. En mi caso me acercó más a mi familia, porque pues estar encerrado, estar ahí, ayudarle a la señora, ayudarle a mis hijos, porque nos fortaleció como pareja. Y lo que sí les puedo decir, como dice Soto Caraz, estamos hechos y preparados para dar espectáculo, independientemente de que sea exhibición o no. Yo creo que la gente va a salir contenta, y los nuevos valores y nuevos, los que van a ser campeones del mundo, van a aprender un poquito esa noche. Muchas gracias.
No questions, we're going to have a face-off.
No! Thank you.
Let's hear it one more time.
Nobody has questions? No?
I got one. Barrera, when you're done with the exhibition, would you want to fight Pacquiao for exhibition?
Well, right now the more important is the exhibition with Soto Caraz, because he's bigger, he's strong. Maybe in the future, we don't know.
Okay.
Soto, since you're coming back, an exhibition fight, or you think that you're gonna ever come back to professional, or do you think you're gonna stick to?
No. My time to pro box is over. No, right now I take the exhibition as my trabalera because it's an honor. It's an honor for me, like exhibition with this guy. But I don't think so. Like I'm back again to fight. No, thank God I am at 50%, like physical, mentally okay. Because for 47 times, I risked my life out of the ring. Yeah. Thank God I'm okay. So I'm not back, I'm back here to fight again for like pro fight. Exhibition is okay, but no pro fight.
Coming back to exhibition, you know, it's been a while since you fought. Do you feel different coming back like for this camp, for this exhibition?
No, for this exhibition, we talk about before this press conference, we always train very hard for when it's up the ring, we do the best. And he's a warrior, me too. When we stay on the ring, everything will be different. But the more important for me is that all the people that come in go to see the good fight.
Are you going to train in the United States or Mexico?
No, I go to train in Guadalajara. I got to stay here 1 week before the show.
Marco, what was the toughest fight of your career, of all the legends you
had? Many. The first tough fight was with Kenny McKinney. And second, I think so, with Terrible Morales. Three tough fights. And the number three with Nassim Hamed, different style, he moved, but I win the fight.
What was your toughest fight so far? My dad?
I fought with anybody, no? But I never forget when I fought my John, the second fight, like third in 24, 2011. I don't forget this fight, okay, he got me anywhere, my knee, kidneys, and my liver, and my arm, for anywhere. And I felt like, I drive back home on Sunday, I drive back to North Hollywood. And Monday in the morning, I went to a restaurant, like everyone went to a restaurant, you know? And I never forget that because, sorry for my work, but I can clean my bath for myself, you know? I went to a restaurant. That was right out in my new corner. I said, oh, that's fine. No, that's not fun because for like 3 days, I don't clean my bath for myself, you know? I don't clean my bath. So that's not fun, right, Barrera? That's not fun. Everybody think, oh, boxing is fun. No, that's not fun. I don't can move my arm for like 4 days, you know? Every day in the morning when I wake up, I tell my wife, it's like a new queen because I don't can move. I don't go under from the barber for myself. So that was tough. Yeah, I think that Barrera here happened too. You had a tough fight. You can move your arm. That's not fun. When you fight, that's not fun. I don't think that's a game. I think that Mike John finished the second fight. You know, I don't know what happened on the ring. June 11, whatever, when two wide was the ring, whatever happened, you know. But I put the arm higher, like the same, that arm fight. I put my heart, like me say, hey, I don't have big ball. I have small ball, but I can call it play, you know? I don't need big ball. Small ball when I play.
What weight are you guys fighting at?
I don't know. I think maybe like, I think like 160, 165. I don't know. I am ready to fight right now.
Oh,
I don't care.
God.
Right? Or what? Or you want to wait to 11, June 11? Right now, right? Yeah, it's a
good condition.
Exactly. It's like, me for like 2018, 2019, 2020, and 2021, I run almost every day. This year, 2021, I run like 10 miles. The first day of 2021, and we say I'm not doing most for 1 year. 2021, I'm not doing most anymore, so for 1 year. So now, I'm in good shape.
Ladies and gentlemen, well, thank you very much for coming out once again, June 11th. Before we get started with the one-on-ones, we're gonna have the sightings of the fighters.
Look at her pimping. Look at the cobra.
All right, guys.
Can I get Caesar and you?
Thank you so much for watching this video, and make sure to subscribe for more videos of your favorite fighters over here on Fight Up TV, and give us a follow online as well at Fight Up TV on Twitter and on Instagram. We appreciate it, guys.